We'll begin the class. Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sahana Bhunaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvinavatitamastu Mavidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. ओम बोलो स्वामी सद्गुरु शिवानंद महाराज की जय। स्वामी विष्णुदेवानंद महाराज की जय। हरि ओम तत्सत। ओम नमः शिवाय। गुड इवनिंग टू यू ऑल। वेलकम टू द सेकेंड डे ऑफ गीता क्लास। बिफोर वी बिगिन द क्लास, इफ एनीबडी हैज एनी क्लारिफिकेशन दैट नीड्स टू बी सॉर्ट और for any of the slokas which we need a little more meaning, just send me a message, send the message in the Shivananda group. I would be answering those on the following day. Good. So far what we have seen is Sanjaya is explaining in an exhaustive way with all the details through the emotions of people standing in the war room to the born blind king Dhritarashtra. So till the fifth sloka, Dronacharya is standing and Duryodhana is going near to Dronacharya and started explaining who are all standing in the opposition party. Who is the opposition party here? Pandavas are the opposition party and the ruling is Gauravas, the Duryodhana's side. With this background, we'll start sloka number 6. Yudha manyuscha vikranta uttamaujascha viryavan saubhadro draupadeyascha sarvayeva maharataha. In this sloka also, Duryodhana is naming the courageous people, courageous men, men of courage and wisdom, who are all standing in the opposite side, in the opponent side, the mighty people who are all standing there. Yudhamanyu means he is known for his potential. Vikrantaha, the most courageous man. Uttamuscha Viryavan, the most daring guy, always wins. Saubhadra, the son of Subhadra, who is Abhimanyu. Who is the son of Subhadra? Abhimanyu. Draupadeyascha, Draupadi's son, Pandava's son. Maharataha, we've already seen this word in sloka number 4. Maharataha means people who have the potential to fight independently, individually. They can fight and win the large number of battalion of people. Those who have that potential, they will get the title of Maharathaha. So all these people who are standing on the opposite side, all their Maharathaha, they have proven for their winning ability. We don't know why is Duryodhana saying all this. Dronacharya, he knows very well, he is also standing next to him. He can see everything, still Duryodhana is going and explaining. Clearly, subtly explaining, the author is telling us that Duryodhana is bringing out his fear. Duryodhana is disturbed. When we are disturbed at home also, we can recollect our experiences. When we are disturbed, though we will, our family people, they will know who have all come and gone, everything they will know, but still we will start naming them, we will start describing their behavior, everything. Everybody will know their behavior. That shows that we are restless. The same way Duryodhana is restless here. he start explaining each and every one. Slokam number 7.
Asmakam tu visishtaye tani bodha dvijottama nayaka mama sainyasya samyatam tan bravimite.
After naming these mighty people in the enemy side, each individual standing in the front, in the opposition side, Duryodhana now, his disturbed mind is still going up. He started talking little nonsense. Whenever we are in fear, we have disturbed mind, our character comes out. As a leader, Duryodhana is a leader here. As a leader, in all conditions, we must always be there to encourage our people. We must always be there to pat our people in the team to scale up. Especially when the situation is not good, the leaders should always be conscious to take the team along with him, not to blame the team. And when they start talking bad about the team, that shows the character of a leader. Here, Duryodhana.
Asmakam tu visishtaye tan nibodha dvijottama.
He is calling Dronacharya as dvijottama. Dvija means twice born. Who is twice born? A Brahmin is a twice born. Dvija means twice born. He is calling Drona, "O Brahmin." That's not a right, nice way to address, right? That shows his quality, his character. He's saying, "O Brahmin." When you call like that, what does it mean? He's not saying by explicit words. What does he mean? You are not a Kshatriya. Only Kshatriya has a potential to fight. You are just a Brahmin. You only know to form strategize. You know to strategize and you only know to teach Veda. You don't know to fight. So he is calling like that, "O Brahmin." Drona is having the bow and arrow. He is ready to fight. He has come for you. He is standing in the battlefield. He is standing next to you. You have gone near to him. And you are addressing him, "O Brahmin." That's not a nice way to do it. However, that shows that his discriminatory power has gone and his indiscriminatory power is creeping up.
Nayaka mama sainyasya.
Nayaka means people. Mama sainya. Sainya means in our battalion. Nayaka mama sainya. Mama sainyasya. See, I will now tell you who are all in my side. He is not saying who are all in our side, who are all in your side. Whenever a senior or respectable people at home or at our workplace or in or around us, if you are humble, we always say that, you know, it is your place, it's your home, like that. It's your people. When you say that it is my people, it's my place, it's my, when you say my, then that shows the ego that prevails in Duryodhana. Nayaka mama sainyasya, people who are in my side.
Samyarte tan bravimite.
Now I will say who are all in my side. Clearly expressing the ego in him. Why these indiscriminatory words come out of his mind? Clearly because he is mentally upset. Whenever we are mentally upset, our absurd behavior comes out. That's because the confused mind, the upset mind. Why upset mind? There is a consciousness deep in us which is telling, maybe what we are doing is for a wrong cause. Here Duryodhana, clearly he is doing all this for a wrong cause. That fear, upset, all these are coming out of him, which is expressed by our author in sloka number 7. Sloka number 8. भवान् भीष्मश्च कर्णश्च कृपश्च समितिञ्जयः अश्वत्थामा विकर्णश्च सौमदत्तिस्तथैव च. नौ हैविंग स्पेल्ट आउट द वर्ड ब्राह्मण कॉलिंग द्रोणाचार्य लाइक दैट, Duryodhana realizes that he crossed his limit. In every relationship, there is a borderline, right? When we cross the borderline, the unpleasantness come. And very soon we realize that the unpleasantness has come out of us. And when that happens, what we will immediately do? We'll try to do something to console that person. Now here, the same way, having realized that he crossed the limit of calling the Acharya the Brahman, he understood and he realized the mistake. In the anger, we use words immediately and we realize immediately we have used the word. Our ego will not permit us to say sorry. So we will find another alternative to go and console the people, do what they like, or speak the words what they like. Here, Duryodhana is using that strategy. He now starts naming out the people who are fond of Dronacharya. So he is now telling who are all standing in our battalion. Bhavan Bhishmascha Karnas. Shloka number 8, correct. Bhavan Bhishmascha Karnascha. Bhishma Pitamaha, the senior most. Karna, Kripacharya, who has always seen victory, nothing but victory in any war. Ashwatthama, your own son. Samitinjaya, Vikarna, Saumadatta, all these are closer to Dronacharya. So he is naming all these people and he says, who are near and dear to Dronacharya. He is naming all these people and he is saying, all these mighty people are in my army. Again, he is using that word, my army, because the ego is still prevailing in his heart. That is what he is explaining in slokam number 7. Moving to slokam number 9. Anye cha bahava shura madharte tyakta jivitaha nana sastra praharanaha sarve yuddha visharataha. Having mentioned these few names in order to show the great people in our army too, he is now saying Anyescha bahava. Bahava means very many. Anyescha, in our side also. Bahava shura. Shura means most courageous heroes. Anyescha bahava shuraha. In our side, not in our side, he's telling, in my side. Anyescha bahava shura. Madarte. They have all come here for my sake. Madartam means for my sake. Tyakta jivitaha. Tyakta means ready to leave. Jivitaha, their life. Jivitam. Jivitam means life. Tyakta means ready to leave. They are all here. All these most courageous people are here for my sake. Madartam. For my sake, they have all come here. Nana sastra praharanaha. They are all well versed in handling the instruments. They are not hanky-panky people. Just like that. No. They are all well versed. Nana sastra praharanaha. All that they have professionally learnt. to use those various instruments in the war, missiles, everything, they are all well versed. Yuddha Visharataha, in the war, Yuddha means war. In the war, they are all well proficient to use all the instruments and Sastra Praharana, use all those instruments in the world war. And they have all come here for Madartham, for my sake. And for my sake, they are here and they are all ready to leave their life for my sake. Again, expressing his ego. Moving to sloka number 10. Aparyaptam tadasmakam bhalam bhishma bhirakshitam paryaptam dvita paryaptam dvidhametesham balam bhima bhirakshitam. Speciality of Sanskrit. Only in Sanskrit, one word which can have two meanings and both the meanings are nicely conveyed here. Paryaptam, aparyaptam. This paryaptam is a word very nicely used in the sloka by the author. Paryaptam has two meanings. One meaning is you can take it as sufficient. The other meaning we can take it as is limited. This can be used for and against. And the sloka has nicely brought out that luxury of the Sanskrit language, the vocabulary. Paryaptam tadasmakam. Paryaptam means sufficient. Asmakam, our army. So he says, Bhishma bhi rakshitam. In our side, who is there? Bhishma is there. That one Bhishma Pitamaha is enough to be guided and guarded. Our army is well sufficient, paryaptam, this is enough to win the war. Bhishma is with us. As long as Bhishma Pitamaha is with us, who is guided and we are all guided and guarded by Bhishma Pitamaha, for sure we will win. In the opposite side, aparyaptam, dvitame tesham, bhalam, bhima virakshitam. Who is there in the opposite side? Who can be little, slightly compare is Bhima. But as long as Bhishma Pitamaha is in our side, we will definitely win the army. So, as a leader, now I am commanding the entire battalion, those people who are all standing in your own position, paryaptam dvitame desham tesham, standing in their own positions, all of you now take this word clearly. Have an eye on Bhishma Pitamaha. All of you, along with your duty, you have one more responsibility now. You have to protect Bhishma. Bhishma, as long as Bhishma Pitamaha is with us, we will definitely win the army. In the opposite side, there's only Bhima is there, still we can win. There is one more way to look at this is in the sloka. Though Bhishma Pitamaha is with us, only Bhima is there, still I feel aparyaptam. We may not. It is insufficient to win. So this clearly, here again the confusion and fear of Duryodhana is explained in this sloka. It can be either taken as paryaptam, Bhishma Pitamaha is enough with us, overconfidence that I will win, or it can be looked at the fear that is creeping deep in him, aparyaptam, though it is there, we have to protect Bhishma Pitamaha and we have to have an eye on him. It is also, though it is not clearly said by words, when you go and stand near Dronacharya and when you say all of you protect only Bhishma Pitamaha, then what is he trying to say? I want only Bhishma Pitamaha. Dronacharya, you cannot win because you are not a Kshatriya. So these fear, confusion, when all these comes, we don't know the usage of words sometimes, though we do not strongly mean to convey those words, it will project ourselves like that. Sloka number 10 is what this says, that we have to protect Bhishma Pitamaha. Slokam number 11. Do we have the time? We have the time for one more sloka. Sloka number 11. Ayaneshu cha sarveshu yatha bhagam avasthitaha भीष्ममेवाभिरक्षन्तु भवन्तः सर्व एवि एवहि अयनेचु सर्वेषु. ही इज टेलिंग द एंटायर बटालियन इन ऑल पीपल हु आर स्टैंडिंग इन इन योर ओन पोजीशन यथा भागम अवस्थिताः मींस पीपल हु आर स्टैंडिंग इन योर ओन पोजीशन. Have an eye on Bhishma. Bhishma eva abhirakshantu. Protect Bhishma Pitamaha. All of you have an eye on Bhishma and protect him. He is telling these words to Dronacharya himself, that Bhishma Pitamaha is indispensable. Though by not by words, clearly that he is indispensable and you are all dispensable. But his words is saying all this. The psychological fear complex coming out of Duryodhana is vividly explained by the author, calling Dronacharya a Brahmin, saying that your Sishya is standing in the opposite, you don't know who all to teach, you taught everybody everything, and going to Dronacharya itself and saying that, you know, protect Bhishma Pitamaha. All these, what is it saying is the mental confusion of Duryodhana, who started talking nonsense. When we are in distress, when we are in fear, when our confusion is reaching its climax, what we will do is we will, by words, we will put our own foot into our mouth. It's like that. All indiscriminatory words come out. We don't even realize that we are hurting people. We are crossing our limits in saying words. All the stupidity will come out. That is what, because that fear in you is irresistible. The fear in Duryodhana is irresistible. He started using all these words. In this sloka, he is commanding the entire battalion to protect Bhishma from any harm. Which means Bhishma is indispensable. That as long as Bhishma Pitamaha is with us, we are guided and guarded. With this sloka, we'll end today's session. Keeping our back straight, we'll chant Om 3 times together, followed by the prayer. Om. त्र्यंबकं यजामहे सुगंतिं पुष्टिवर्धनं उरुवारुकमिव बंधनात् मृत्योन्मुक्षीयमामृतात्. ओम त्र्यंबकं यजामहे सुगंतिं पुष्टिवर्धनं उरुवारुकमिव बंधनात् मृत्योन्मुक्षीयमामृतात्. ओम त्र्यंबकं यजामहे सुगंतिं पुष्टिवर्धनं उर्वारुकमिव बंधनात् मृत्योन्मुक्षीयमामृतात्. ओम सर्वेषां स्वस्तिर्भवतु सर्वेषां शान्तिर्भवतु सर्वेषां पूर्णं भवतु, सर्वेषां मंगलं भवतु, सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः, सर्वे सन्तु निरामया, सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु, मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत्, असतो मा सद्गमय, तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय, मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय। ॐ पूर्णमदा पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमाधाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
सल्युटेशन्स् टु मास्टर्स्। ॐ बोलस्वामि सद्गुरु शिवानन्द महाराज की जय। ॐ बोलस्वामि विष्णुदेवानन्द महाराज की जय। हरि ओम तत्सत्। ओम नमः शिवाय। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर गिविंग मी दिस ऑपर्चुनिटी। थैंक यू। एंजॉय अ ब्यूटिफुल इवनिंग। सी यू टुमारो।